relationship goals that she does and wants to have them and fulfill them with her. This is of paramount importance. Most women are giving up their exclusivity for men who have not stated that they want the same things that they do and that they don't want to have them with them. Just because somebody says that they're not sleeping with other people doesn't mean that they have any intentions of marrying you or having a family. And women are often stunned to find out a year into a relationship the guy doesn't really think they're truly compatible.
Sometimes it's just difficult to like let someone else come in and provide that cushion. Sometimes it's just a challenge, and so that makes it more difficult for black women to be as open and as, you know, willing to accept some of the other things that come along with having a partner.
With the change of women's status in society, marriage is being profoundly transformed. And what I love about the women's movement is I've always seen it as a liberation movement for both women and men. And that both women and men could move beyond their roles into who they authentically are.
Now I'm back at a stage where, I mean, I've only been dating Jessica for 2 months, but we're living together. I mean, we're committed. And it's like, I mean, honesty is it. Communication and honesty is the key.
When will all this settle down? I've got a star, I've got a star. Putting it on, I've gotta be honest. It's not a lie, it's not a lie.
But I think the real benefit beyond all of that, which I certainly honor, is that it frees up your life. It frees up bound energy, repressed energy, held energy. I don't know what, but somehow you suddenly feel alive. And when you feel alive, you realize you missed that. You lost that when you were little. And when you feel alive, everything is alive. The trees, the birds, the rocks, the universe.
I totally have a fantasy of becoming stronger with another person, feeling like my life has more meaning because this other person is in it, because I have somebody to share everything with. Somebody who cares if I have success or not. You know, like, all of a sudden that somebody who just likes me just to because of who I am.
It's true. I mean, we talk within our relationship of, you know, feeling like we just fell in love again. And love is, it's like an indescribable thing. It's communication, it's caring, it's tenderness, it's, you know, affection, it's
knowing that, you know? It's knowing, as far as marriage is concerned, it's knowing that you couldn't be the same without your spouse.
Right.
You wouldn't be the same person that you are without your spouse.
Hell, let's break it down to Grandma Brick Dog. The stages in life, you know?
You're born and you're a little kid, and then you get into teen years.
If you're lucky, you fall in love, and then one day you get married, and then
you start building the home. That's another stage. And then you get so involved, if you have children, you get so involved with them that you, even though we never did forget each other or did always kissed goodnight, you kind of go your separate ways. He was busy with his work, and before I started working out, I was busy with the house and doing all those things. And then the kids start leaving. And then after they're gone, that's a complete another stage of your life. Then you have to adjust all over again. You don't fall in love all over again because you're already in love, but it's a different kind of love. It's a more respectful type of love.
I went to visit a man. His name was Sid, 92 years old. And he was dying. It was his last day of life. I'd seen him once before, and now, you know, it was pretty clear he was going to die in the next few hours. And I walked into the hospital room, and there was Helen, his wife, by his bedside. And I was so privileged to just stand there in that room and listen to the two of them whisper to each other before he died. And he just kept saying her name, "Oh, Helen, oh, Helen, oh, Helen." And she leaned over the railing on the bed and kissed him on the forehead and said, "Sidney, thank you for taking such good care of me for so long." And he said, "Thank you." Very fortunate people. You know, to have had someone hang in there with you for 50, 60, 70 years. That's a pretty rare treasure, you know? That's worth it. That's worth it.
I can talk to her intellectually. I can talk to her as a friend. I can talk to her about anything. Like, dude, every time I look at her, I'm like, I cannot believe how gorgeous this woman is, and she's with me, and she's mine.
When I look into your eyes, I can see forever is gone.
And she loves me for who I am. God knows Red Dog has some shit. I got some baggage.
I knew the Jessica thing was real screwed up in the beginning. Instantly saw that, met her real early on before they moved to Canyon Lake, and I went, "Holy shit, Ryan, why are you doing this?" And, you know, it's not his kind of person.
It was a day trip. My dad and I went down there, and we're on our way back, and she tells me when I get there at the house that she's like, "Well, I'd actually like for you to get your stuff and decided that I just want to live there by myself." And I'm like, obviously, like, what? Yeah, I mean, basically how it opened my, it was obvious that, shit, I freaking opened my heart up wide open.